Hi everyone, my name is Kevin. Today I want to show you how you can get Microsoft Office, which includes such popular programs like Word, Excel, and PowerPoint, entirely for free. It won't cost you anything. I work at Microsoft and this is the product that I work on, and today I'm excited to tell you about it. Okay, let's jump onto the desktop. Here I am on my desktop and I'm going to show you two different methods how you can get Microsoft Office for free. The first one uses your browser, and so whether you're using, say, Windows 10, whether you're using Mac, or whether you're using Linux or Chrome OS, whatever operating system you use, you'll be able to take advantage of this. So let's open up I'm going to open up the Chrome browser here, and I'm going to go into incognito mode. And what I'm going to do is we're going to go to the website office.com. So office.com is how you're going to get to be able to use Office for free. So on the office.com website, you'll see two different options. One is Get Office. The other option is Sign In. Now, if you click on Get Office, that's a marketing site where you could purchase the offline version of Office, or you could purchase a subscription. But I mentioned that we want to get free Office, and to get free Office, what we're going to do is we're just going to click on Sign In. Okay, so make sure you click on the button that says Sign In. And once we do that, we're going to get the Sign In prompt. Now, if you don't have a Microsoft account, don't worry. It's very easy to create one. And creating an account is entirely free. It doesn't cost you anything to create an account. I happen to already have one. If you have a Skype account, if you have any other type of account, you already have a Microsoft account. So I'm going to go ahead and type in one of my demo accounts that I have. So kevstrat2@outlook.com. And I'm going to go ahead and click on Next. And now it wants me to enter my password, so we're going to go ahead and type in my password. You could click on Keep Me Signed In if you don't want to sign in again in the future. And so what this will do now is this drops me off on the office.com website. And so you'll see a few different things on here. I have all these different options, and the first one says Start New. So I'm going to click on this Start New button. And what you'll see is I could create a Word document, I could create an Excel workbook, I could create a PowerPoint presentation. You also have other stuff like being able to create a form or a survey. You could also create a Sway. So there are many different things that you could create from this site. I said I'd show you how to use Microsoft Office for free, so why don't we go ahead and create a Word document. I'm going to click on Word document, and so what you'll see happen now is it's going to drop me in a brand new document. So here I am in the Word interface. Here I could rename the document to something else. So maybe I'll call this, let's say, Kevin YouTube Star. That's right. Maybe not quite. So here I am in my document, and I can type away. This is an example. You could, apply different styles, different headings. You have all the typical functionality of Word. So I'm going to go back to office.com now. What you'll see is I could also click on this Word tile. So if I click here, this will drop me on the Word start page, and I have a whole bunch of templates I could choose from. If I click on more templates, I have a whole bunch that I could start from. And then here I have my list of recent documents that I've been working on. I could also pin or see shared with me. If I go back, I could also click into Microsoft Excel. Looks very similar to the start experience for Word. And then here I could also click into PowerPoint, and you get the idea. I get all the different apps. Now, one of the things that I love about this is I also have this recent list down here of all my documents I've been working on. So what I could do is, here I could click on it and I could pin it. I could remove it from the list. I could open the file location. So lots of things I could do with the file. What I can also do is, let's say that you have a document you've been working on your computer, and now you want to work on that using this office.com experience. What you could do is there's this upload and open button here, and if I click on that, what I could do is I could select a Word, an Excel, or a PowerPoint file, and then I could upload that and continue working on it online. Now, let's say that I have a document and I've been working on it on office.com and I want to work on it just on my machine, or maybe I want to send it to someone. So let me go back to my Kevin YouTube Star document here. And what I could do is, so I clicked on the file menu. So I'm going to click on the file menu. And within the file menu, there's an option that says Save As. And if I click on Save As, what I could do is I could download a copy. So that'll just download the document, or the docx, to my machine. I could also get it as a PDF. And so there are other formats you can also get. But so if you don't want to just leave it in the cloud, you could also just get it off. Now, a few of the things that you'll see is all of this, the Word, Excel, PowerPoint, this is all available online. So you need an internet connection to be able to take advantage of it. But as long as you have an internet connection, you have a browser, you can use this entirely for free. If you want offline access, though, that's where Microsoft charges you then. So if I see this, you see this install button here in the top right-hand corner. So if I click on that, I get this little upsell message that says Go Premium with Office 365. So if I want the app on my computer, I have to pay for it. I also have the option here just to buy Office 365 in the top right-hand corner, so I could do that. And so I mentioned that I would show you two different ways how you could access the Office apps. The second way that you could get to all your Office apps is with an app called Office, and it comes on your PC if you have a Windows 10. So what you do is you simply click on the search area down here in Windows, and then you type in Office, and it should pop up as the best match. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on the best match Office, and this will load the Office app. So here I am in the app now, and you'll see that it looks very similar to the office.com experience. The one difference, though, is if you look at the documents that are shown here versus the documents that are shown here, in the app I see a lot more documents. And the reason why is a bunch of these documents are stored on my computer. And so the Office app not only shows me all of my cloud documents, but it also shows me documents that are just on my computer. And so I, you know, when I look at these two different experiences, I actually prefer using the Office app because not only do I see cloud documents, but I see local documents as well. So I'm gonna go back for a moment, and so that's how you get Office for free. I also wanna show some cool functionality that you get with Office. It's not necessarily related to getting it for free, but a few things that I wanted to show. So not only do you get Word, Excel, PowerPoint, here if I click on all apps, you get a lot more than just Word, Excel, PowerPoint. So you know, here I get a calendar, I get Flow where you could set up these different routines or tasks. You get an app called Forms, which allows you to set up surveys and quizzes. You also get OneNote, which is an awesome note-taking program, which I use all the time. You also get things like Skype for calling. You get tasks. You get Sway, which is, you know, setting up these interactive views or kind of interactive experiences on the web that you can then share with others. So you get all these really cool tools with Office.com. So it really goes beyond just Word, Excel, PowerPoint. And now one other thing that I want to show before I wrap up this video. If I go back to, let me go back to office.com, and I'm going to click on this document called Sample Co-op Document. So we're going to open that document. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to put it side by side with let me open up another window that I have. And I'm also in this document. And so this is the window on the right is logged in with a different account than the window on the left. And so what I could do now is, let's say I type in here. What you'll see is the text that I'm typing in the right window automatically shows up on the left window. So let's say that you're working with 5 or maybe 10 people. You can do real-time collaboration using Word, using Excel, using PowerPoint. What's also cool is, so not only can you all work at the same time, but now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna click on review. And so I'll leave a comment in here. So I could put in a comment and I'll say, hey, please review this. And so I'm gonna leave a comment. And so now what I can do is I'll jump into my other window, and you could see, let's see, I'm gonna show all comments, and here you can see the comments. So not only can you work with other people on a document and see what they're doing as you're working on it, but now you could comment back and forth as you're working on the document. So you get Word, Excel, PowerPoint for free. You also get real-time collaboration. You also get commenting. You get a lot of rich functionality in the web apps. One thing to call out, the web apps, they're not quite as feature-rich yet as the apps you get on your computer, which is why Microsoft still charges for the apps that come on your computer. But the web apps are pretty good. They're constantly adding new functionality, and they're getting better and better and better. And one of the nice things is, if there's something that's not in the web app that you want, there's this button in the bottom right-hand corner that says give feedback to Microsoft. So I could click on that. You could say whether you like something, you don't like something. So if I say I like something, you could type in a comment. But this is where you could request functionality. And just from experience, when you request something, it gets added pretty quickly. You know, in Excel, they recently added pivot tables. And so a lot more functionality is coming to the web apps. Anyway, that's all I have for you today. I wanted to show you how you could get Microsoft Office entirely for free. It's completely legal because Office.com, the Office app, these are provided by Microsoft. So you could use Word, Excel, and PowerPoint. You could create documents, spreadsheets, presentations, and it won't cost you anything at all. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more videos like this, please hit that subscribe button. And if you have any other questions or comments, leave a comment down below in the comments, and I'll try my best to respond. Anyway, I'll see you next time. Thanks for tuning in. Bye.